Hello there and welcome back to Midlife Crisis. I'm Cheryl, trying a new something here. See how it goes. We have moved over into the springtime. It's daylight savings now in this neck of the woods, which means that it will not get dark until 8 o'clock. We have longer days now. I absolutely hate when it gets dark at 4. It's just so depressing. The days are so much shorter. So I'm by the water and you'll be hearing a little shh. I hope you don't mind. I just love being by the water. It's so tranquil and it helps me to think. On this channel, we basically cover midlife issues because it's just so much of it. So if you are visiting for the first time, this is what goes on here. Welcome. This week, I'd like to talk about the struggles in finding your peace and happiness in midlife. So don't go away. We are approaching the summer and we're doing it rapidly. We had like 67 degrees, just like Wednesday in the New York area. And it's such a different atmosphere when it's warm. I love the warm weather. It's kind of exciting to have the different seasons, but I basically like the warm weather. So we're in spring now, and hopefully in the next few weeks, we'll be going into the 60s and 70s consistently. So that would be good. The sunshine has a lot to do with enhancing your mood and, you know, your personality. So happiness, it's something that we said comes from within, but you can't, like, if you're a person like myself who is gregarious and is always looking to find your peace and happiness and just be excited, it can be shut down by being in the wrong environment. And that can easily happen in midlife. Oh, and by the way, I do have my mask. I hope you're using yours. I just felt like putting it aside for today. But it's kind of challenging because if you are just a person that appreciate being happy every day and just looking to each day to see what new is coming, and you're around someone or people for that matter that are just seeing darkness or is miserable within themselves, that can actually tamper with you having your peace and happiness. And as sad as it sounds, that is basically what happens. Because in midlife, you know, you've already hitched up possibly with someone, a husband, a wife, a partner. And if you're not with someone and you're living alone, it could be a neighbor, it could be, you know, your friends, family members. I mean, it's always something that can try to interfere with your balance. And when I say balance, I mean your peace and happiness, because if you don't have that, you cannot be balanced. So what do you do in a situation like that? You really have to just choose your environment, choose your friends, and just try to clip the ones that are not syncing with you. It is hard to even find your bearings because every time you turn around, it's something you've got to be careful of. And to just have people that are not versed on being happy or having a good relationship with others, it's not easy. And you always have someone that's preying on someone else that are trying to keep it together. It's sad, but it's true. And so this is why I talk about emotional intelligence a lot, but I also cover watch who is in your circle, because that can shake your grounds. That can actually interfere with you having the peace and happiness that you're thriving for in midlife. I try to cover these things because I myself have challenges with it. And you know, you're not alone in the world, and so you can't control everything that happens to you and around you. So what do you do when you are enclosed or are interacting with individuals that are not syncing with you? You've got to make adjustments, because there's no way you're going to be able to bloom or keep your happiness, keep your peace with people who are thriving to make you crazy while you need to keep your head balanced and clear. So just pay attention to that and do what you have to do to make the adjustments, because we talked about manipulative and abusive adult children. That we have to tolerate because it's our children. And I'm still saying you have to find a way to work with that. But you do not have to undergo any kind of silliness or abuse with anyone else. And that means family members, friends. You do not have to put yourself through that. If the relationships are not working, it's not working. Your focus should be to keep yourself balanced, healthy, and happy. And I'm sorry, it sounds selfish, but that is what we need to do. Because it's just too many things going on around us to have to be putting up with unnecessary stuff. So if you're able to identify with the abusers that is serving no purpose in your life, there is no reason, and even if they are serving a purpose, you do not need to be around anyone that makes you feel badly, try to put you down, or is competing with you. It's just so much that goes wrong, and because you're in your midlife, you are experienced with abuse. You know what it is. So when you're able to tell what's going on, step back and get rid of it, because you have to bloom and you have to stay healthy and happy. It's the only way. So at the end of the day, we all should be looking for our happiness, not to be a footstool for anyone, not to accommodate any kind of abuse and disrespect. End of story. You've got to pay attention to that. There are a lot of miserable individuals, and it's in all areas, on your job, in the household, the neighbor, you know, it's all around. You just have to try and fix it where it does not get to affect you. Everyone's looking for someone to pay for what's going on in their lives. Be careful and pay attention. You're not here to be abused by anyone. You're here to try and make yourself happy and to stay healthy. And the way you can do it is by being versed on what you need to make yourself happy, and then get rid of the candidates that are threatening that. And again, you're not being selfish. You're being protective of yourself, as you should be. We are not here at this point to get any kind of abuse. I mean, we're already tolerating these behaviors from our adult children, and sometimes our spouse or our partner. And the only ones that we really should be looking to work that out with is with our children. Everyone else, it should not be tolerated. And I'm even saying to give tough love to a child that you've given birth to. So why in the world would you put up with that from anyone else? You should be looking for your happiness in every way, form, or fashion, and shutting down anything that tries to threaten that. Call it selfish, call it what you want. You have to be able to bloom. And the only way you can do that is by being conscious of self and your environment. Check us out at midliferises.com. We are working on some updating, but there's still a lot of free inspirational readings there for you. So visit us at midliferises.com and subscribe to the channel so that you'll be kept abreast of everything that's going on. If you have something that you'd like to have discussed, please feel free and drop us a note, okay? And we will see you next time. Take care.